Well, here I am again. Just wanted to show you how easy the setup was. I haven't actually gone through this myself, so I don't know if it's easy or not, but we'll see. First thing, obviously, turn on the keyboard. My video quality is not the best, so we'll see how this works out. Pretty obvious, you know. Apparently the arrow keys on the keyboard let you select. Kind of makes sense. It's hard to tell from the video, but it's actually going between back and next. So I'm going to obviously go next. It says that it's going to take about 20 minutes. Let's see how long it actually takes. Okay, this just wants to extend the screen. So you just go through this to make sure that you are not losing any space on your screen, which is pretty nice actually. See any blue left, so I can go ahead and go on to the next step. Yep, everything looks good. Right now I've connected it just by Ethernet cable for ease and to make sure that everything goes seamless right now. Okay, so it looked for system updates and I would hope that there's no updates considering that this just came out today, but we'll find out. It's restarting the box currently. And here we go, it's starting back up. Seems like it takes a few seconds, but not too bad. And I think that it's updating right now. I'm not sure if you could actually hear that or not, but that actually seems like it was the fan in the Revue unit that just powered up. Otherwise. Checking for updates again, you know. This time I would assume that it's not going to find anything. Well, thank you. Okay, so I have to sign in with my Google account. Right now I'm going to opt out of setting usage, but, you know, I might start that later on. Gotta read through the license agreement. Seems like it's a pretty standard thing. Asking for my zip code. And now it's just going to ask me about my system and my setup to see how they exactly need to connect. I actually have Verizon Fios here.
He was good! He was fantastic!
And
he
has just like
a great role as a trouble team. Very emotional. A lot of people were surprised.
Of course, you know, we have Jimmy Fallon on right now. And it just says to select next if I see my TV, and I do see the TV. Just go through and just select my service provider. Seems like they have a few here. And I am on Verizon Fios. And now I'm just selecting my set-top box, which is the 6416. So it just asked me if it tuned to channel 32, which seems to be the PBS around here. I think it's just checking to see if the infrared blasters are working, which they seem that they are. And yes. Asking me if I get CNN, USA, and ESPN, which I do. For premium channels, I do not. Okay, so now it says that it seems that the TV service is complete. You can change channels, look at the guide, and maybe get to my DVR. Okay, so now it's asking me to set up for my TV. I have a Samsung. And, model number is LN. Okay. And now it's just what input is it? It's on that one. So now I can turn my TV on and off, go to the review box and control the volume on the TV, although I do have a surround sound system. So now it's asking me about my surround sound system, which is actually not on this list. Ironically, it's a Logitech item that's not on the list. And it actually is the example that they give me. And there we go. It's asking me what actually is my sound. I don't actually use the sound on my TV. Everything goes through the Logitech receiver. Okay, so now my receiver turns on and off. It can go to the review box and it controls the volume. Okay. It's an overview of everything that I just put in.
Congratulations on setting up your new Logitech review.
Well, that seemed like it was a lot shorter than 20 minutes, considering, including the update, we are currently at 13, almost 14 minutes. So that video was kind of cool, and it's restarting the box again. Okay. It wants me to go through a few of the key features, which I guess I can separate. Till next time.